Someone once said, if it was raining brains, Roxy Robinson wouldn't even get wet. In all of New York, they didn't come much dumber than Roxy the Weasel. To be frank, Roxy was a dope.
Shoulders! The alleyway, quick! He's heading for burritos. Benny, cover the back! Yonkers, watch the sidewalk.
Dumb as Roxy was, he could smell trouble like other people could smell gas. But he never should have taken that blind alley by the side of Perito's bakery.
Hey, you Robinson?
Uh-huh.
Roxy Robinson?
Uh-huh.
Also known as Roxy the Weasel.
Uh-huh.
The same Roxy the Weasel that works for Fat Sam. Oh, okay.
Whatever game it was everyone was playing, sure as eggs is eggs, Roxy Robinson had been well and truly scrambled. Now as you can see, something kind of fishy's going on here. To be perfectly honest, I'm beginning to wonder what's going on myself. I mean, the play only just started and already the stage is full of stiffs. Oh, by the way, you're probably wondering who I am. My name's Malone, Bugsy Malone. With an Italian mother and an Irish father, I'd naturally grown up a little confused. I didn't see much future as a spaghetti waiter at Mama Lugini's or pushing a pen at City Hall, so I drifted from this to that. You know, walking the line, trying hard not to fall either side. Until, that is, the night I walked in here to Pop Becker's bookstore. Hey, how you doing? I'm Bugsy Malone. You a dancer? A singer, right? Oh. A baseball player.
Zip the lip, YZ. I'm in no mood for conversation.
What, you don't like me?
Listen, YZ, I'm surprised you don't stoop with that dandruff off your shoulders.
You can come in now. If she's here about the audition, Bugsy, she's got a long wait. Every day they tell me to come back tomorrow.
Now, you might be wondering what kind of crazy place this is with people disappearing into bookstores. Well, firstly, this neighborhood ain't for dumb bums. And secondly, this bookstore ain't no bookstore. This is Fat Sam's place. Fat Sam's Grand Slam. The liveliest joint in town.
Anybody will soon walk through that door at Fat Sam's Grand Slam. Speak easy, always able to find you a table that's room for just one more at Fat Sam's Grand Slam. Speak easy, once you get here, feel the good cheer like they say in the fall. Fat Sam's ain't humble, but it's your home sweet home. Plans are made here, games are played here, I could write me a book. Each night astounds you, rumors are buzzing, stories by the dozen. Look around your cousin at the news when they make it here. Anybody who is, anybody will soon walk through that door. At Fat Sam's Grand Slam. Sitting by the kitchen, said he caught his fingers in the well he was wishing. Once you get here, feel the good cheer like they say in the fall. That sounds ain't humble, but it's your home sweet home. Plans are made here, games are played here, I could write me a book. Each night astounds you, rumors are buzzing, stories by a dozen. Look around your cousin at the news we're making it. Anybody who is, anybody will soon walk through that door.
Going, will you?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm truly sorry. Oh, it's you, Dandruff.
Don't worry. I've had a shampoo since we last spoke. That baseball bat could be classified as a dangerous weapon, you know.
Well, my mother made me pack it.
You're a sports nut?
No, it's for protection, in case I get robbed.
You're a singer, right?
That depends your taste in music. I'm here about a job.
Did you get the job?
They said come back tomorrow.
They always do. What's your name, anyway?
Brown.
Sounds like a loaf of bread.
Blousy Brown.
Sounds like a stale loaf of bread.
And keep your jokes behind your teeth, Wisey.
Pleased to meet you. I'm Bugsy Malone.
Okay, everybody. It's okay. Nothing to worry about, just a little excitement, that's all. Razzmatazz, music. I want to see everyone enjoying themselves. Free drinks on the house. No one can say about Sam in the live in town. This means trouble, Knuckles.
Read all about it, new weapons for mobsters. Read all about it, new gang war for flares. Read it in the record, read all about it.
We interrupt this program of music to bring you an important news flash. Reports are coming off in a gangland incident on the Lower East Side involving a certain Robert Robinson, known as Roxy the Weasel, believed to be a member of the gang of alleged mobster gang Fat Sam.
So tell me how you let this happen. Roxy was one of my best. What have you got to say for yourselves, you bunch of dummies? Knuckles? Ritzy? Angelo? Snake Eyes? Call yourself hoodlums. You're a disgrace to your profession. And most of all, a disgrace to me, Fat Sam. And we all know who's behind this, don't we?
Sure, boss.
And we don't need a handful of brains to know that, do we?
Certainly not, boss.
We all know who's monkeying us around, don't we?
Sure do, boss.
Then who is it then, you dummies?
Dandy Danny, boss?
Don't you dare mention her name in this office.
Boss, how about my audition? You said come back tomorrow.
Am I going mad? Are my ears playing tricks on me? Come back tomorrow, Fizzy.
But today is tomorrow, Mr. Sam.
Will you get out of here?
You okay, boss?
Careful, boss, you'll break something.
Break something? Sure, I'll break your dumb neck. Dancers, dancers, I'm surrounded by a bunch of useless dancers, singers, piano players, banjo players, tin whistle players. In a time where I need brains, you hear me? Brains and muscle.
You got us, boss.
You mean your face, you great hunk of lard. Your problem is you got more muscle than you have brains, I tell you. What are you laughing at?
Nothing, boss.
Can I give you a lift?
Do you have a car?
No.
Then how are you gonna give me a lift, Buster? Put me in an elevator?
I mean, it's a nice night. We could walk. Which way are you going?
Which way are you going?
I'm going that way.
Then I'm going this way.
Let me carry your bag at least. Have you eaten?
Ever since I was a child.
Yeah, then how come you're so skinny, smarty?
Hey, I watch my weight.
Yeah, I do that when I'm broke too. You hungry?
No.
You're not hungry?
No, I'm starving.
So, are you going back to the speakeasy tomorrow?
No. I'm gonna try my luck at the Bijou Theater.
The Lena Morelli show?
She walked out. They're looking for a replacement.
Oh, she walks out every week, and every week they have auditions, and every week she walks back again. But don't let me put you off.
You won't. What do you do?
Oh, this and that.
Oh, crooked, huh?
No, not quite. I find fighters, boxers. In fact, I used to be one myself. Pretty good, too.
You were?
Sure, I could have been a champion.
You could?
Sure, but for a couple of things.
Like what?
Like jelly legs and a glass jaw.
Some champion.
I mean, I do well for a couple of rounds, but I was about as tough as a ball of cotton wool. This jaw had more glass in it than Mace's window. One punch was all it took to send me back to the dressing room, generally on a stretcher. They'd slap my face, get out the smelling salts, and I'd come round kidding myself it was just a lucky punch. How many times can it be a lucky punch? Then I wised up before my face ended up looking like a plate full of mashed potatoes.
I could have been a contender, Charlie.
Look, buddy, in case you're wondering, I ain't part of the furniture. So are you eating or are you eating?
No, we'll have 2 banana boozles with double ice cream and nuts and chocolate sauce, 2 Arizona cream donuts, and a Coke with 2 straws. Can't keep meeting like this.
Okay, all, relax. Well, I've I'd like to take this opportunity of thanking each of you for your hard work so far. Everything's gone swell. Just swell.
Thank you, boss.
Fat Sam must have had quite a shock. It was always my destiny. I had my future tailor made for me. I'm on a winning streak, so don't try to stop me. Don't try to hold me down, and don't try to top me.
There's a pie in the sky, and it belongs to me. I'm the legal owner of the recipe. The upper crust looks up to me. Didn't you know, gang?
We're getting to see. That's why they call you and me.
I rule this town with a velvet fist.
Oh yeah, that's our name.
I got a sense of humor that they can't resist.
It's a deadly dance.
I give this plot a lemon twist.
Shoulders, Yonkers, Benny Lee, any moment now, Fat Sam will be crawling on his knees to me.
I didn't get a flower, boss.
Soon, all Fat Sam will have is the clothes he stands up in and a suitcase full of memories.
But what about my flower, boss? I didn't get a flower.
You goofed, Doodle. You've dropped the gun, and I don't allow mistakes in this outfit. Because mistakes could put us all in the caboose, and Sing Sing ain't my style.
No, boss, please no. I didn't mean to drop the gun. Honest, I didn't. It just kind of slipped out of my hands. You know, any guy can make a mistake.
Indeed. And I am nothing if not personable. So you, Doodle, have the honor of securing your place in history by being the first to try out the new improved Splurge Gun Mark II.
Gee, can I really try it out first?
Indeed you can. Stay where you are, Doodle. At close range, things get very messy.
No, boss, please no.
On your lip, Doodle. You're all washed up.
cracking your knuckles, Knuckles.
But it's how I got my name, boss.
Well, knock it off or change your name. Tallulah, honey, are you ready? How long do you expect us to wait?
Coming, honey. You don't want me looking a mess, do you?
Boss, how about my audition?
I'm busy right now, Fizzy. I promise you, tomorrow.
But yesterday you said tomorrow, boss.
Tallulah, honey, how long do you expect us to wait? You take more time in the day than there's time in the day.
Listen, honey, if I didn't look this good, you wouldn't give me the time of day.
I'll see you in the car. Don't do that, Knuckles.
Sorry, boss. Night, Fizzy.
Night, Tallulah.
Next!
Vila, oh, which are the ones?
Next!
But I have other songs.
Yeah, honey, you have other voices? Next! Come on, guys. You gotta show us what's on here.
Good evening, I'm the great Marvin, illusionist to kings. I've been privileged to have obtained second billing at theaters in Missouri, Bangkok, and Pattaya. And I will perform to you a trick only seen by the crowned heads of Europe. From this hat, I will produce not one rabbit, not two rabbits, but three rabbits.
Okay, next. Don't give up your day job.
I wish they'd hurry up. I get nervous waiting.
Oh, quit worrying, will you?
Well, I didn't count on this many people.
Yeah, but this bunch are all conjurers and magicians by the look of it. You've got no competition, believe me.
How do I look?
You look great.
I look a wreck.
Ugh.
Hello, everybody. Well, how are you, Clarence? Don't ask. I suppose you're wondering why I'm here.
Oh, you bet. Next.
What does he mean, next? Doesn't he like us? Doesn't he know we are? I'll punch that sucker in the nose!
Blousy Brown, singer.
The light, honey.
Sorry, Mr. DeVille, I didn't catch that.
The light, honey. Move into the light so we can see you. The music quality set in mineshaft. Name?
Blousy Brown, singer.
Oscar, I'm back! Give me one last chance, else I'm out for good! Out! Okay, honey. Beat it back to Iowa. This show's got its star back. Hit it, Joe!
I'm in show business. I traveled far. That's right, you got it. A neon star. I started at the bottom, but I reached the top. And once your name didn't let you know, you'll never stop. Show business is all I need. Give me the chance and I'll take the lead. When the music's playing, I can't help but sing. And when the dancer's swaying, I'm right in the swing of it. Show business, it's lucky it breaks. A chance to show it.
Cheer up. There's a million other jobs.
Yeah, on a street corner with a hat to cash the dimes in.
It's only a matter of time. Look, cool it, will you?
I've been walking the streets of New York for 6 months now, and the only fancy steps I've done so far are avoiding the man who collects the rent.
So it takes time to be a movie star. We could always come back tomorrow.
Come back tomorrow. That's all I ever hear. I spend my whole life coming back tomorrow.
Knock it off, will you, Blousy? Cool down.
I will not cool down. I will not.
I mean, there's always Fat Sam's place.
He won't see me.
I'll talk to him.
You know him?
Know him? We're like that.
Real good friends?
No, not quite. It's just that when I talk to him, I cross my fingers that he won't hit me.
We interrupt our commentary on tonight's exciting Red Sox game to bring you a further update on the latest hoodlum gun warfare. Police now officially state that the new weapon is known as the Scourge Gun and is being widely used by mobster gangs. Our reporter Samuel Scoop is on the scene.
Have you located the Scourge Gun yet, Lieutenant?
I'm afraid I can answer that.
You're not at liberty to say?
No, I don't know the answer.
Have you located the source yet?
Sure, I had it on my hamburger for lunch.
No, the source of the guns.
Oh, yeah. No. I'm not at liberty to say. You have to ask Captain Smolsky that question.
Okay, O'Dreary, bring this crowd up. Let's go, guys. Split. This is police business and police business. We've got to do.
Saber Scoop, RTZ Radio. Captain Smolsky, can you tell us if you've located the splurge guns yet?
No comment.
Have you located the source?
No comment.
Captain Smolsky, is it true that the guns are being used by only one gang?
No comment.
Captain, I fixed you a pastrami or rice sandwich, Chief.
No comment. Okay. Get out of here.
Captain, I found something.
What is it, O'Dreary?
A brush, Captain?
No, what have you found?
A gun, Captain?
What kind of gun?
A big gun, Captain.
Knucklehead, I sent you on a 6-month fingerprint course, and all you can tell me is it's a big gun?
As you've probably gathered, Smolsky and O'Dreary have about as much chance of solving this case as I have of being President of the United States. Apart from the subway home, the only thing Smolsky ever caught was the flu. Meanwhile, back in our story, Fat Sam is definitely getting a little nervous. I mean, if you had a gang of dumb bums like this to rely on, you'd be nervous.
Sorry, boss.
Quit cracking your knuckles, Knuckles.
Sorry, boss.
I swear, I'm surrounded by a bunch of nervous wrecks. All right, let's start at the beginning. We're being outsmarted by that lounge lizard, right?
Right, boss.
And we're gonna get right back on top, right?
Right back on top, boss.
We're gonna kick that drugstore cowboy right in line, aren't we?
You bet, boss.
Sure, we've been a little slow off the mark, but when it comes to the crunch, dumb bums we ain't.
No dumb bums we ain't.
All right, I'm going to show you knuckleheads where we're going wrong. Pickett, stand against the wall.
Who, me, boss?
Are you Shakedown Pickett?
Sure am, boss.
Are you the same Shakedown Pickett that used to be Harvey Sleendeckers before I gave you the name?
That's right, boss.
Then stand against the wall, porch brain. Snake Eyes, hand me a pie.
A pie, boss? What'd I do wrong? Talk to me, boss. Tell me what I did wrong.
See, miss, get back in line. Even a dumb monk like Pickett is too quick for us. That's the root of our troubles. We're behind the times.
But I don't get it, boss.
We're never going to get on top with this kind of hardware. It's old, obsolete, defunct. In short, we got to get ourselves that gun.
Thank you. spill some?
Spill, Shady, spill!
You know the laundry?
At East 14th Street?
That's it. Second floor, behind the laundry.
Good boy, Shady. This is good news. I'll be sending my boy.
Good work, Shady. You earned your money.
Thank you, Nanimam.
Sam's boys went for quite a party. Now, get out of here. Betty Lee, if there's one thing I can't abide, it's a two-timing canary. Just a day's work. Like running a railway or shoeing a horse.
Sam ain't gonna like this.
Well, he ain't gonna do nothing about it. Without his gang, he's like a tortoise without its shell. Soon, he'll be thrown in the towels.
What? I don't believe it. Everyone? Splurge? I just don't believe it. I just don't believe it.
Knuckles, that's everyone. They've all been killed. Splurge! That Lee's just use and me's, Knuckles. Just use and me's.
What are we gonna do, boss?
Stop doing that, Knuckles. I keep saying this. We do nothing. We act like nothing's happened. Tata casa sono bueno.
What's that supposed to mean?
You don't speak Italian?
No.
You claim to be a hoodlum and you don't speak Italian.
I'm Jewish, boss.
We play it cool. We act normal. Go see who it is, Knuckles. Act normal.
It's the broad about the audition. Come back tomorrow, Lee. He's busy.
Wait, honey, I'll be right with you. Go powder your nose or something. Knuckles, acting normal means acting normal. So they don't know that we're scared to death. I mean concerned. That buys us a little time, thinking time. In that time, I'm gonna call up for a professional to help us.
Looney Bergonzi.
The same office hat, mad as a hatter, Bergonzi, the best man in Chicago. Here's what we do. I will call up Dandy Dan. We'll meet with her. Me and Bergonzi will be in the back of the car. You drive, Knuckles.
Right. But I don't drive.
You don't drive? Oh, hello. Is this Dandy Dan's residence? Can I speak to herself, please? Oh, don't worry about who it's from. To say it's from Mr. Sassetto. You don't drive? Then we gotta get ourselves a driver, then.
Hello. Hi, Sam. What can I do for you?
I'd like to meet up, Dan. Do a little talking.
Where?
At East 14th Street, five ways. Lexburg and Denver, you hearing me?
Yeah, I'm hearing you, Sam. But you come alone. No hoods, mind.
No hoods. What's she talking about, no hoods? She's wiped out all my hoods. Just you and me and our drivers, Dan.
Agreed. Got him, the knucklehead.
Got her, the bozo.
No,
Hey, Fizzy.
Hi, Bugsy.
How are we doing? Still practicing?
Still practicing.
Have you seen Blousy? I thought she was here for our audition.
Well, she was here, but she went to get some fresh air. She got tired of waiting. Well, she left her bag here, so I guess she's coming back.
Thanks, Fizzy.
Suddenly, everyone wants to be in show business.
Oh, hi, Tallulah.
He's busy, Bugsy. Why don't you have a drink while you're waiting?
Sure, why not? I'll have a special on the rocks.
Hi, Bugsy.
Hi, Loretta, Bangles, and Tilly.
Okay, girls, go feed the ducks.
Tallulah.
I said, beat it. Long time no see, Bugsy.
Oh, you know how it is.
You used to come and see me every night.
I've been busy.
Oh yeah? Busy doing what?
Oh, this and that.
Hey, Fizzy, will you quit dancing and hit the shoe leather? You're aces, you know that, Bugsy? I've always found you kind of special.
Careful, Tallulah. You're racing my motor.
Oh, come on, Bugsy. Give a girl a break.
You sure you got the right guy?
Well, you're not like all those other saps.
No?
Got lovely brown eyes.
There'll be lovely black eyes if Fat Sam catches us.
Come on, sugar. How about smearing my lipstick?
Tallulah, I'm warning you. If you come any closer, I'll call my lawyer.
So call him.
Blousy, I was just looking for you.
Hush your mouth, jerk.
Ready, boss. The broad's ready for her audition.
Honey, I'm all ears. Contemporary for my taste, but all the same, very good. You're hired.
Great, Blousy. That was really swell. I told you you'd make it. That was terrific, really terrific. Blousy, what's the matter with you? Look, I can explain all that to Lula smoochin'.
Bugsy! How'd you like to earn yourself some green stuff?
As long as you're not talking about cabbages, what's the catch?
No catch, just straightforward driving.
Knowing you, Sam, it'll be ducking and driving. What's the pay?
200.
Cents?
Dollars!
Dollars? Sounds like dangerous driving.
It could get a little heated, but you don't get $200 for driving a milk truck, Bugsy.
Okay, you've got yourself a driver.
Good, good. Knuckles, fetch me a drink. I'm getting a little thirsty. Bloodthirsty!
Hey, Bangles, is Blousy there?
She won't see you, Bugsy. She's mad. She was holding a torch for you higher than the Statue of Liberty.
Look, just tell her I'm sick, will you?
You're sick?
Yeah, sick of waiting here.
I'll see what I can do, but don't count on it.
Beat it, YZ.
Give me a break, Blousy. I've brought you some flowers.
I'll see Tallulah gets them.
Quit being so smart, okay? They're for you.
Look, I've gotta go.
I'll see you later.
Yeah, like 10 years later.
I've got a job.
You don't get paid standing in bread lines, Buster.
A legit job. We'll have enough money for 2 tickets to the coast in Hollywood. Who knows? They're always looking for new stars.
Oh, yeah, sure. I'll believe it when I see it.
Look, just trust me, okay?
Sure.
All I know. Never trust anyone who says trust me. But I was on the level. Honest I was. I wanted to buy her the tickets, but first I had to earn the 200 bucks driving Sam and Looney. Looney Berganzi. Boy, when they said he was off his trolley, they weren't kidding.
Quick, Bugsy. Here she comes. Is she alone?
Yep, looks like just Dan.
Okay, get Looney. Looney. Keep your head down, keep your body low. Wait till I give you the okay, all right?
Hi, Sam. What can I do for you?
How about a small dose of straight talk, Dan?
Suits me.
You've been taking liberties, Dan.
I've been taking what's mine.
Trouble is, it belongs to me.
Too bad. Possession is 9/10 of the law, Sam.
Well, hold on, Missy. I've been in this game a long time, yous and me's. I'm sure we can talk over these things sensibly. After all, I'm a businessman.
You're a dime a dozen gangster, Sam.
You watch your mouth, Missy. I ought to have some respect.
You slit your own throat for 2 bits plus tax.
You keep your wisecracks behind your teeth, Missy.
Keep talking.
I have my position to think of.
Right now, your position ain't worth a plug nickel.
You dirty rat, Dan.
You've been watching too many movies, Sam.
Okay, Looney, let her have it!
Yonkers, Charlie, quick, it's a double cross!
Good job, Bugsy. Here's your $200 and an extra $100 for your quick thinking.
Gee, thanks, Mr. Staccato.
No problem. Just buy yourself a new suit. Get out of that dirty rag you're wearing. Here's the name of my tailor.
Thanks, Mr. Staccato.
And think nothing of it. Right now, let's get out of here.
He's a sinner. Friends, he always seems to be alone, but they love him, Bugsy Malone. City slicker, he can charm you with a smile and a style of his own. Talk about Tallulah, you know what?
Yeah, sure. I'll get her. Blousy, it's for you. Give him my love.
Hello?
Hey, Blousy, it's Bugsy.
Where are you?
Oh, around. Listen, I can't talk to you now, but I've just made 200 bucks.
You mean you printed it yourself?
No, I earned it, swear to God.
Doing what?
Oh, this and that.
Who for?
Fat Sam.
Fat Sam gave you $200?
And the loan of his sedan for the afternoon.
I don't believe you, you're putting me on.
Look, if you get yourself outside the Grand Slam in 10 minutes, look for the snazzy sedan with the good-looking driver, and you'll find he has a very close resemblance to yours truly, okay?
Okay. But you better not be putting me on, Buster.
Cross my heart, it's on the level. So long.
Which one's mine?
Say, Blousy.
Sort of.
I'm giving up, guys. They're nothing but trouble, believe me. From now on, I'm looking for husbands, and I ain't getting too attached. I'm gonna change him regularly like a library book. Hey, don't you think I look cute? What do you think about the dress, Tilly?
I don't know. It's...
Come on, Tilly, just say what you really think.
Well, I don't know, Bangles. Maybe the color's wrong.
What are you talking about? Purple's my color. I always wear purple.
Yeah, it matches the veins in your legs.
Well, maybe it's the length.
It's the latest length. I read it in the magazine.
Or maybe it's the frills. They stick out too much.
They match your ears.
Do you think it'll look any better on you?
It'll look better on a horse.
You're just jealous. Can I help it if my looks are ahead of my time?
They're what?
Full of personality, character, kind of earthy.
Yeah, like a bucket of mud.
Mustard with onions, ketchup without.
Ketchup without. Do you really have $200?
Nope.
Oh yeah, you lied.
No, I've got $198.10. I just bought 2 hot dogs.
You didn't do anything crooked, did you?
Of course not. I just got it for driving and helping Mr. Sam out of a little predicament. Oh, I nearly forgot.
What's this, a finger bowl?
No, a present, Wisey.
Oh, Bugsy, for me?
Well, I didn't buy it for the audience.
It's wonderful, fantastic. What is this?
It's a viewer, dummy. Look, you turn the knobs and you can see all the Hollywood stars.
Oh, if only I can actually get to Hollywood.
You could. I mean...
Sure, wise guy, I've heard that before. On the front row of the Roxy in East 38th Street.
No, really get to Hollywood. I've got $198.10. What does that buy?
440 hot dogs.
No, 2 tickets, stupid.
2 tickets?
On the Super Chief.
Super Chief?
The train, dummy, to Hollywood. Think about it.
Tickets?
Huh? Yeah, 2 tickets.
Matter of fact, I'm forced to admit it. Caught in the act that maybe we've hit it. Is this strange now feeling something that you're feeling too?
So, what's the answer?
Did you honestly think it would be anything but yes? Oh, Bugsy, it's Hollywood!
Knock it off, will you?
You're putting me on!
It's the honest truth, I tell you. It's just that if I don't get the sedan back soon, Fat Sam will have my face looking like a plateful of yesterday's fettuccine.
Uh-huh. I think I found something. Come and take a look at this, Jerry.
You have cracked it this time, Captain Smolsky.
I have? What do you see? Tell me, what do you see, Jerry?
Your foot, Captain?
Not my foot. Knucklehead, under my foot. Tire marks.
Oh, it's tire mark. All right, Captain.
To write a tire mark, you dummy. Get some plaster. We'll take a mold. There ought to be more marks. They're sure as X is X with more than one sedan around here. Hey, what's this? Ah!
Gee, Captain, I'm sorry, sir. I didn't see you there. Honestly, I didn't.
You dumb idiot!
Couldn't have to, Captain. It was an accident, honestly.
If I catch you, Jerry, I'm gonna punch that stupid nose of yours!
Are you sure this is going to work, boss?
Of course it is, Knuckles. Stop doing that. It looks like a splurge gun, doesn't it? Doesn't it?
Yeah, you're right, boss.
Anything Dandy Dan can do, Fat Sam can do way better. Am I right or am I right?
Yeah, you're right.
Sure. Now, get set, Knuckles.
I'm ready.
Ready? Fire! Miss, back to the drawing board, Knuckles. Knuckles? Knuckles! Knuckles, speak to me! You greasy lounge lizard, I'll get you for this! Poor, poor Knuckles. Poor, poor Knuckles.
As you can see from the mess here, things are looking kind of untidy in Fat Sam's life. And as for Knuckles, well, whatever game he was playing, he'd sure cashed his chips in. And as for Smolsky and Captain O'Dreary, well, Smolsky started out with the intention of chasing O'Dreary back home, but he forgot that he had quick-drying plaster all over him, and very soon, he was stiffer than some of those hoods he occasionally pulled out of the East River. Anyway... Hello? Is anybody there? Are you... Huh? Ah!
They take your money, mister?
Yeah, $200 less 90 cents. It was sure nice of you to help me like that.
Oh, it was nothing.
You must be a boxer, right?
Nope.
You aren't? But that was the best darn punching I've ever seen.
Oh, it was nothing.
You ever been coached?
Nope.
You ever thought of taking it up? I mean, professionally?
Nope.
Why not? You could be a champion.
Never thought about it.
I know someone who could help you. Do you know Cagey Joe?
Nope.
Do you know Slugger's Jim?
Nope.
You don't know much, do you?
Nope.
Put it there, Leroy. You've got yourself a manager. Hey, KG Joe.
Hi, Bugsy. How you been?
Swell, KG Joe. Real swell. And you?
For me? Yeah. But this bunch of punchbacks? The pits.
KG Joe, I want you to meet the next heavyweight champion. Leroy, meet KG Joe. KG Joe, meet Leroy Smith.
Ever been in a ring before, boy?
Nope.
So you're one of your fighter, huh?
No, not exactly.
Oh, sure he does. Look at those mitts. Have you ever seen such fits? Hit it, Leroy.
What's your name again, kid?
Leroy Smith.
With you showing him the ropes, KG Joe, he could be a champion in no time.
Okay, I'll give him a try, but I'll tell you now, he'll be no good unless he got it.
It? What's it?
It is the difference between being a no-hope or slugger and being a champion.
It's what makes a fighter special. If you haven't got it, you just haven't got it.
So you wanna be a boxer in the golden ring? Can you punch like Southboy Freight Train? Tell me just one thing. Can you move like a whirl, like a hummingbird's wing if you need to? Can you bob, can you weave, can you fake, can you see when you need to?
So you might as well quit if you haven't got it.
So you wanna be a boxer, can you pass the test? I can tell if you got it in you, I've trained the best.
When you work and you sweat and you bet that you train till a bus sore. When you kneel, lose your mind and you find that your boy has a glass jar.
So you might as well quit if you haven't got it.
Put him in the ring, Joe, look at what you found. We can use the fun, Joe, pushing him around. We'll show him the ropes and destroy his hopes. Put him in the ring, Joe, give the guy a chance. Let him feel his thing, Joe, we can make him dance. We'll pop him to bits, then he'll call it quits. For sure, Joe.
So you wanna be a boxer, wanna be the champ. There's a golden boy inside you, not a punch-down tramp.
If you listen and you learn, there's an honor you can earn and defend here. When you do see the crown, you're a king, not a clown, a contender.
So you might as well quit if you haven't got it.
Boss, they got to the still. They had axes and chopped away at the barrels. It's all gone, drained away, every last drop.
Get right over here right now, Pickett.
I can't, boss. I'm all tied up.
I don't care how busy you are. Get round here right away. Well, that's the whole empire gone, Tallulah. That leaves just this place. There's only one thing for it. You gotta get him to help me.
Who, the Lone Ranger?
No, you dumb Dora. Bugsy Malone. Call him. I'm in trouble. Real trouble. And all I got for company is a female comedian.
No answer.
I want you to go ask him poisonally.
Poisonally?
Poisonally.
Poisonally. So long, lover boy. Hi, Bugsy.
Blousy! Oh, it's you, Tallulah.
I like my men at my feet.
What are you doing here, Tallulah?
Put your flaps down, Tiger, or else you'll take off. I've got a message for you.
So, what's wrong with Western Union?
Don't flatter yourself, Tiger. It's Sam who wants to see you, not me. Now let's go before your suspender belt strangles you.
I'm waiting for someone.
You are?
Yeah, for Blousy. We're going to Hollywood.
Well, you know what they say. Don't pack anything you can't put on a train home. Sam's in trouble, Bugsy, and I'm sure he'll see that you're okay.
I'll be right there.
Quit humming, Fizzy. It makes me edgy.
Sure, boss.
Careful, boss. The floor's wet. You no good broom pushing hoofer! I'll break that mold over your dumb neck! Oh, hi, Bugsy. How'd you been?
Fine, Mrs. Taketo. And you?
A little difficulty at this moment. Follow me. Tallulah, honey, will you fetch Bugsy dear a drink?
What's your pleasure, Bugsy?
Special on the rocks, Tallulah, please.
Follow me. Here, have my seat.
Thank you.
To be frank with you, Bugsy, I'm in a jam. Danny Dan's breathing down my neck, and any day now, she'll be taking over my entire organization.
But you still got all of this.
I won't have a dime for a shoe shine if Danny Dan gets her way.
Nothing?
Not a red cent.
What Sam is trying to say, Bugsy, is that he needs your help.
My friend's gone. My gang doesn't want to know me. My business ain't worth a hill of beans. In short, I need you, Bugsy.
Me, Sam? Why me?
Because you're no mug. You've got brains up here, not pretzels.
No, rough stuff ain't my line.
Help me, and there's $200 in it for you, plus the $200 you already have.
Impossible.
I thought you were smart.
Impossible because I already lost the first $200.
You lost $200 on a horse?
No, I was mugged.
Tut tut. Too many dishonest people these days. A hoodlum ain't safe on the streets. Here, have $200, plus the $200 you lost.
$400?
Well, do we have a deal?
We have a deal.
Hi, is Bugsy there, please?
Bugsy, it's for you. It's Blousy.
Excuse me a minute, Sam.
Sure, use the phone all you like. Phone home, phone Europe, phone everywhere. After all, if Dandy Dan takes over this place, she'll have to pay the phone bill.
Hello?
Bugsy, is that you? Why are you there? We said 8:30 and you're an hour late.
Something came up.
Like what?
Like business.
Oh yeah, with Tallulah.
Not with Tallulah, Wisey.
Did you get the tickets?
No, not yet. I told you, something's come up.
You promised me, Bugsy. You promised me.
I know. But this is business, Blousy. It can't wait. Hollywood can.
An hour I've been waiting here, Bugsy. And at first you didn't show up. I give you the benefit of the doubt. But then I got nervous and called every pool hall dive in the phone book. They hadn't seen you, but boy, did they all know you.
Get off, Tallulah.
You rat? You two-timing rat?
Leroy. Hey, Leroy, wake up. Come on, Leroy.
Who is it? What do you want?
It's me, Leroy. Bugsy, get dressed and come with me. We got a job.
You got me a crack at the title already?
No, this is a different kind of job.
I'm tired, Bugsy. Come back in the morning.
It'll be too late in the morning. You'll be working for Fat Sam Staccato. You'll be hitting Dandy Danny where it hurts. And there's $200 in it for you.
I'll do it!
Come on, this place is like a morgue. We're not on Poverty Row yet. Let's have a little music, shall we? Oh, hi, Blousy. I thought you were on your way to the coast.
It fell through.
Shame.
Mr. Sakeno, do you think I can have my job back?
Sure, go in. The more the merrier.
Your train.
Hi, Blousy. What happened? Your guy let you down?
Hi, Blousy. How have you been?
Did you ever see a broad carry a torso high?
You know, the Statue of Liberty.
There's a truck pulling up. Splurge guns.
Where?
On the crates, stupid. Look what it says on the side of the crates.
I can't.
Can't you read?
No, I'm just a little short-sighted. What does it say?
It says, Splurge Imports Inc., Dock 17, East River. This must be where they keep the guns.
Well, then let's go.
Oh, hold your horses. There must be a dozen guards there.
There are?
Yeah, two on the roof, two on the side, and two in the front. It's no use, just the two of us. What are we gonna do, Leroy?
Go home?
No, there must be a way in.
Don't be stupid, Bugsy. We'll never slug our way through that lot.
I guess you're right. We need an army to get through.
No armies around here, Bugsy.
What's that?
What?
Listen.
To sit around complaining about the way your life has wound up. Think of all the time you waste, and time's a precious thing to let go by. Sure, you've hit the bottom, but remember you'll be building from the ground up. Every day's another step that takes you even closer to the sky. So give it a try. To sit around depressed about the way that luck deceived you. Fortune sailed away, you missed that boat and found that you'd been left behind. Fight and fight some more until you know the world is ready to receive you. Lady luck is fickle, but a lady is allowed to change her mind. Complaining about
All right, there they are, all ready for the taking. Get baby face.
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 Get baby face. Get baby face.
Wait, who am I kidding? I'm baby face.
Give this to baby face.
Give this to baby face. Give this to baby face.
Give this to baby face.
Give this to baby face.
Give this to baby face.
Wait, no, actually.
Baby face, get out there.
Baby face, you're the star of the show right now. Get to have courage, baby face. Courage, baby face. Geronimo!
Wait!
And with your hands up in the air.
What are we gonna do now, Bugsy?
I don't know, Leroy.
Right. This is your last warning. I'm gonna start counting now. One. Two. Three. Four. Five.
Six, Captain Smolsky. The next number is six.
I know. Six. Seven. Eight.
Look, another way out.
Okay, quick, let's go, everyone.
I'm warning you guys. Don't think I'm bluffing. We'll be coming in and it will come to you. Nine, 10, 11. Okay, three. This is it. 10. We're going in.
Whenever you say, Captain.
10.
10.
Ready? Now.
Okay, gang, this is the caper that's gonna take the lid off of City Hall. This is the big one.
The big one.
The shakedown.
The shakedown.
This is the payoff.
The payoff.
It's gotta be good, gotta be quick, gotta be neat.
Gotta be good, gotta be quick, gotta be neat.
Quit repeating everything I say. You shouldn't have any trouble. Just salmon a few dance hall girls. Remember, when you get inside that speakeasy, keep those fingers pumping. Because this will be history you'll be writing. Too kind, too kind. And now, for Fat Sam's Grand Slam.
Right, Leroy, babyface, you guys make sure you're hidden. Blousy, are you gonna get out of the way? Else I'm gonna have to take someone else to Hollywood.
Sure, YZ.
Two tickets to Hollywood.
Oh, Bugsy!
Bugsy, they're here!
Okay, everyone act like normal. Girls, off you go, let's hear you. Music, razzmatazz, hit the ivories.
Well, what can we say? I'm staggered, actually. As soon as we came in the auditorium, right the way from the FOBP welcoming us and having that real sense of Bugsy Malone and the whole atmosphere, so we're really, really impressed. I'm sure everyone here agrees with me that was absolutely amazing. The amount of time that you had to prepare for this, your costumes, the acting, the singing, the dancing, and I think nobody was actually hurt, hopefully, during the... Apart from Mr. Green. Mr. Green, you okay?
Yes, I'm okay.
I just wanted to say a few thank yous. This doesn't actually come together by accident. There's a lot of hard work, as you can imagine, and the benefits of confidence and self-esteem and the singing and dancing and collaboration is absolutely amazing. I do need to thank some people. It is written down, so I don't forget anybody. So, first of all the school staff that were supporting this event and coping with the students being at rehearsals this week, so thank you to them. And also I realise there's quite a few people who've been not very well this week across the whole school and the whole community, so well done. The admin support, including Kuntar and the marketing team for helping arrange the new ticket system, which I see you all got a seat, so it obviously worked. All the staff that work behind the scenes, including Kelly Abley, Adele George, Laura Hira, Kunti, Wit, and our theatre techies as well, Kun Bank and Kun Yok at the back. Kun T for our fabulous sets and props. I think you'll agree that's absolutely the best I've ever seen. It really is a West End quality. Mr. Hugh Conway is somewhere over there, I think, with the colourful lighting, and a special mention to Dan O'Shea for choreographing and also the directing and coping with all the microphones. And a mega big thanks to Mr. Simon Green, Kun Pao, and their fabulous band, especially Kun Pao. So big thank you to everybody. Thank you. A huge and most significant thanks to Amy Hurst for putting on this entire thing from a concept to tonight. So thank you. Where are you, Miss Hurst? We do have some flowers, I believe, some flowers to be delivered. So please, please can you deliver some flowers to Mr. Green? And an ice pack, maybe. Thank you. And also some well-deserved flowers to Miss Hurst over here. Thank you. Hearing the feedback from the year 5 and 6s today as they saw the dress rehearsal was absolutely amazing. What an inspiration you are to the younger children. So thank you so much. You have been fabulous. Thank you. I think in true theatre tradition, we have an encore. You got one more song you can do? Okay, I'll take it away. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.